You should have seen type 1 regions and type 2 regions a long, long time ago. Way back when, right when we learned how to integrate functions, we had application of integration to find the areas of regions and to find the volumes of solids of revolution. And we're going to revisit those ideas in light of two-dimensional integrals, because back then we were doing one-dimensional integrals, and now we're doing two-dimensional integrals. We want to see, where did those one-dimensional formulas come from? What does it have to do with two-dimensional geometry? So the first basic fact is, if you want to figure out the area of a region, you can do that by just integrating the function 1 dA. After all, you take 1 times the area of a box, you just get the area of a box. You add up all the boxes, and you get the whole area of the region. That's pretty darn easy. Now, if you have a type 1 region, what does that mean? It means we're integrating the function 1 from g of x to h of x, and then that gives us the area of a column, and then we integrate that from a to b, and that gives us the total area. So the area of our region is the integral from a to b, the integral of g of x to h of x of 1 dy dx. Now, 1 is a pretty darn easy function to integrate. The integral of 1 dy is just y. So we evaluate y at h of x and g of x, and we'd get h of x minus g of x. And that's just the height of the column. The height of the column is the position at the top minus the position at the bottom. The height is h minus g. So we've gotten that the area of R is the integral from a to b of the height dx. Well, of course, that's exactly the same formula that we had back when we were doing applications of integration. And the reason that it was a one-dimensional integral is it really was a two-dimensional integral, but the first integral was so easy we could just write down the answer. Now, if you had a type 2 region, it's the same thing in reverse. You want to figure out the contribution of each row. So you integrate from g of y to h of y. And you get that the area of R is the integral from c to d of the integral from g of y to h of y of 1 dx dy. And integrating 1 dx is easy. We get x. You plug in at the endpoints. And you get the integral from c to d of h of y minus g of y dy. And that's just the integral of the width of the row dy. Again, the exact same formula that we saw way back when we talked about areas. Okay. The next thing we talked about way back when was solids revolution. So let's suppose we have a region up here. It's sitting above the x-axis. And we want to figure out what happens when we rotate it all the way around the x-axis. So we're going to take a little box, and if we spin the box all the way around the x-axis, we're going to get this little ring. And the ring, if you want to figure out the volume of the ring, it's the cross-sectional area times how far it goes around. And how far it goes around is it's a circle of radius y. So the box sweeps out a ring of circumference 2 pi y, and cross-sectional area delta x delta y. And so the volume of our solid revolution is going to be the integral of 2 pi y dA over our region. Now, how do we do that? Well, that depends on whether it's type 1 or type 2. Oh, by the way, if you were rotating around the y-axis, you would say that the radius is x, so it would be the integral of 2 pi x dA instead of 2 pi y dA. If you were integrating around the x-axis, it's 2 pi y dA. Okay, so let's evaluate that integral a little bit more. If we have a type 1 region, we have to integrate the inner integrals from g of x to h of x. The outer integrals from a to b, and we're integrating 2 pi y dy. What's the integral of 2 pi y dy? Well, that's just pi y squared. Pi y squared evaluated at h and g gives you pi times h squared minus g squared dx. Now that formula should be very familiar. That's the formula of the area of a washer. And this integral from a to b of the area of a washer dx was the volume, the way that we got volumes of revolution by the washer method. So you can think of that as coming from this two-dimensional integral where you happen to integrate dy first. Well, what if you got a type 2 region? If you got a type 2 region, you're going to integrate as x grows from g of y to h of y, and then as y goes from c to d. Well, now integrating dx just gives you x, because y is a constant. So that gives you 2 pi y, h of y minus g of y, dy. And that's what we got from the cylindrical shell method. We're really saying the contribution of this row is the width of the row, that's h minus g, and then we rotated the row around the x-axis, and we got a cylindrical shell. So the cylindrical shell formula is what you get from the double integral, treating it as a type 2 region. Now, if we had been rotating about the y-axis, then it would have been the type 1 regions that gave you shell and the type 2 regions that gave you washers. But the point is, in all cases, you can always write the area, the volume of the solid revolution as 2 pi times the radius, times how far you are from the axis, times the area. If you integrate one variable first, you get disks or washers. If you integrate the other variable first, you get cylindrical shells.